Hello students, welcome to today's lesson on writing chemical equation. We'll be going through the key steps in writing chemical equation and the examples to actually apply the steps. So first of all, the key steps in writing chemical equation, the first step is to identify the reactants and products. Second is to write down a chemical formula for each reactant and the product, followed by the third steps of balancing the chemical equation. Lastly, to add in the state symbols. So we'll go through the first example. Okay, so the first example is hydrogen gas reacts with oxygen gas to form water. Okay, so in this case, the reactant is hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So the clue is forming, which will tell you water is the product. So the second step is to write down the chemical formula for the reactant and product. So for hydrogen gas, it will be H2. For oxygen gas, it will be O2. And water will be H2O. Okay, now coming to the third step, which is the most important one of balancing equation. So we'll go through the several intermediate steps to balance equation. So first is to go from left to right for each element. We count the number of atoms and then write down the number at the top of the element. Okay? So we'll follow through the steps first as we go along. First, for hydrogen, we have 2 here. For oxygen, we have 2. So now we move on to the product on the right hand side. For hydrogen, we have 2. Oxygen, we have 1. So now for step D, we check if the number of atoms for each element is balanced for reactants and products. That means we check the left-hand side and the right-hand side. So, as we go from hydrogen, we have 2 here. Okay, on the right-hand side, we also have 2. Okay, so it's balanced. Now we go through oxygen. Oxygen, we have 2. On the right-hand side, we only have 1, so it's not balanced. So in this case, let me change. What we do is, if it's not balanced, we add a number to the reactant or product where the atoms is lesser. So what we do is we add a 2. Okay, in this case, let me erase here. Okay, so in this case, our hydrogen become 4, our oxygen become 2. Okay, now we repeat step C to E to see if the equation is balanced. So we go from left to right. For hydrogen, we have 2, so on the right, we have 4. So what we have to do, we add in a 2 to make it 4. So we do a check, 4 and 4, okay, it's balanced. So for oxygen, 2 and 2 is balanced. So this is our balanced chemical equation. Okay, so now we go to step 4. Okay, we look for clues in the question to determine whether it's gas, solid, aqueous, or liquid. So for hydrogen, it is a gas, so the state symbol is G. For oxygen, it is also a gas, so the state symbol is G. For water, the state symbol is L. So hydrogen will be H. Hydrogen gas will be G. Oxygen gas will be G. Water will be L. So now we need to add in the numbers to make sure it's balanced. So this is 2. This is also 2. So this is our balanced chemical equation. Okay, so now we move on to the next example. Okay, example 2. We have sodium metal reacts with chlorine gas to form sodium chloride. So in this case, the reactant are sodium metal and chlorine gas. So the product will be sodium chloride. Okay, step 2 is to write down the chemical formula for the reactant and product. So for sodium metal, it will be Na. Chlorine gas will be Cl2. Okay, sodium chloride will be NaCl. Okay, now we go through step 3 on balancing the chemical equation. Okay, so how do we do it? So remember, we go from left to right. Okay, for each element, count the number of atoms and then write down the number at the top. Okay, let's do it. Okay, so for sodium, we have 1. Chlorine, we have 2. Sodium is 1. Okay, chlorine, we have 1. Okay, now we check is the number of atoms balanced for reactant and product. Okay, so for sodium we have 1, okay, it's balanced. Okay, for chlorine we have 2 over here. For chlorine it's not balanced. So in this case, what we need to do, sorry. So in this case, what we need to do is to increase or add in a number to the reactant product where the atoms is lesser. So what we do here, we add in a 2 so that our sodium become 2, our chlorine become 2. So let's check from left to right, see whether it's balanced. So for sodium, we need 2 on the right hand side. So here we also add in a 2, it's become a 2. Okay, let's check. 2 and sodium is 2, so it's balanced. For chlorine is 2 and on the right hand side is 2, so it's balanced. So this will be the balanced chemical equation. Okay, so now we look for the state symbol. So clues in the question, for sodium, okay, it is a metal and the state symbol is S. For chlorine, it's a gas, state symbol is G. For sodium chloride, it's an ionic compound that has higher melting point and boiling point, so the state symbol will be S, okay, in this case. So now we add in the numbers, this is 2, this is 2, so that is a balanced chemical equation. Can? Okay, now we move on to the next example. So the example will be zinc metal reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to form salt and hydrogen gas. So in this case, we have 2 reactants and 2 products. So the first reactant will be zinc metal, the second will be dilute sulfuric acid, and then the product will be salt and hydrogen gas. Okay, so in this case, now we move on to step 2, which is writing the chemical formula. For zinc metal will be Zn, for dilute sulfuric acid will be H2SO4, for salt will be ZnSO4, zinc sulfate. For the hydrogen gas will be H2. So now step 3, same thing, we go from left to right for each element, count the number of atoms, write down the number at the top. Okay, so we go through the steps. Okay, first zinc we have 1, okay, hydrogen we have 2, sulfur we have 1, oxygen we have 4, zinc we have 1, sulfur we have 1, zinc, oxygen we have 4. Okay, then for hydrogen we have 2. So we check if the number of atoms for each element is balanced for reactants and products. Okay, so we go from left to right. Okay, for zinc we have 1, on the right hand side we have 1, so it's balanced. For hydrogen we have 2, okay, on the right hand side is also 2. Sulfur is 1, same thing is 1. Oxygen is 4, so on the right hand side is also 4. So in this case, our chemical equation is actually balanced without us adding any numbers to balance it. So this will be the final chemical equation. Okay? So now step 4, same thing, we look for clues in the question. For zinc, it is a metal, so the state symbol will be solid. For sulfuric acid, soluble in water, so the state symbol will be equals. Okay? For zinc chloride, it's an ionic compound that is soluble in water, so it's actually aqueous. Okay? For hydrogen, it's a gas, so it's G. So remember earlier, we didn't add in any numbers to the chemical equation. So in this case, this will be the balanced chemical equation. Okay, now we move on to the last example. In this example, we have thin gas that burns in oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. So in this case, the reactant is ethane gas that burns in oxygen. So the word produce will give you a very good clue what are the products that follows after. We have carbon dioxide and water vapor. So now second step is to write down the chemical formula for each reactant and product. So for ethane gas is C2H6, oxygen is O2, carbon dioxide is CO2, and water vapor is H2O. So now we come to the third step, which is the most important step on balancing equation. Same thing, we go from left to right for each element, count the number of atoms, write the number at the top. Okay, so let's do it. So carbon we have 2, hydrogen we have 6, oxygen we have 2, carbon we have 1, oxygen we have 2, hydrogen we have 2, oxygen we have 1. So now we check if the number of atoms is balanced for reactants and products. So we go from left to right. So carbon we have 2. Okay, so on the right hand side we only have 1. So what we need to do, okay, we, if it's not balanced, we add a number to the reactant where the atoms is lesser. So we add a 2, this will give you 2 and 4. So let's check. So 2 and 2 is balanced. Okay, so for hydrogen we have 6. Over here we only have 2 on the right hand side. So what we need to do, we add in a 3 to get 6 and 3. So we know that 6 and 6 is balanced. Now we look at oxygen. So on the left hand side, oxygen only have 2. So on the left hand, on the right hand side, we have 4 plus 3 equals 7. So if you notice here on the right hand side, we have 7 oxygen, which is an odd number. On the left hand side is O2. So all the numbers will be in even. So what can we do is that we can add in the intermediate step of writing 7 over 2. So 7 over 2 times 2 will give you a 7. So in this case, you'll get 7, so that is balanced. So to do this, to balance the chemical equation, the final equation, we can multiply the entire equation by 2 so that it will be balanced. So what we can do here is we multiply by 2. So this will be 2, this will become 7, this will become 4, this will become 6. Okay? So what we do here, let me go through with you. Let me erase the top. Okay. Okay, so for carbon, we have 4. For hydrogen, we have now 12. So for oxygen, we have 14. Carbon here, we have 4. Here, we have 8. Here, we have 12. Here, we have 6. So let's go from left to right. 4 and 4 is balanced. So hydrogen, we have 12 and 12 is balanced. And oxygen, we have 14, which is 8 plus 6, which is 14. So this entire equation is balanced. Okay, so now we look for clues in the equation, okay, for the state symbol. So for ethane, this is a gas, so it will be G. Oxygen is a gas, it will also be G. Carbon dioxide is also a gas, so it will be G. So take note here, this is water vapor. So water vapor is actually G. So the state symbol for this equation is actually all for, will be in G. Okay, so now we transfer down the number. So this is 2, this is 7, this is 4, this is 6. So this will be the balanced chemical equation. So after going through this example, we hope you managed to learn how to write chemical equation and how to balance them. So that's all. Thank you.